WRSI first went on the air in 1981 as a small, locally owned radio station in Greenfield, Massachusetts. The station has experienced many changes over the years, including a move to Northampton in 2001. But through all the ups and downs, one thing hasn't changed: the music they play and their commitment to the community they serve. To celebrate 40 years of WRSI, producer Dave Fraser talked with some of the people responsible for the Western Mass radio station's success over the years.
That's the Felice Brothers on the River. I'm Joan Holliday. I came here 11 years ago.
Coming up in 10 minutes, we'll play Get the Connection.
I started here in 2002. I was basically a glorified intern and sometimes lucky sidekick to the morning show host at the time, who happened to be Rachel Maddow.
I was mostly, as I recall, the midday host, and I was the music and program director.
My name is John Riley, and I'm known as Johnny Memphis because that's the radio name I took when I started working at WRSI in 1986.
It was a loan for $60,000 to build the tower, $20,000 for operating costs. I said, "What's operating costs?" And the guy at the bank says, "That's so you could operate for at least 3 months until your cash starts coming in." Oh, that's a great idea. So there it was. Got on the air at noon, July 26, 1981, and our first disc jockey, Phil Drumheller, Phil D, did the first broadcast.
Ed started the station literally himself, built the equipment in the studio himself. When I got there, the music that was programmed was Ed's record collection, literally.
We're running reel-to-reel tape machines because there was no digital back then. We ran records and tapes.
This goes out to Dennis down in Hadley. He wanted to hear some Fats Waller.
We played like jazz, blues, reggae, pop, country, folk, singer, songwriter. It was really quite a wide mix. I had a lot of shows, but I did eventually really end up in the afternoon, which was really the best place for me because, for one thing, I got to interview all these amazing musicians who were coming to the area who would play live in the studio.
We've got Joe Ely and John Hyatt in the studio. Joe, what'd you have for breakfast this morning?
Quiche and caviar.
People like Taj Mahal, who of course is from Springfield, and Dan Hicks, and, you know, B.B. King. I interviewed B.B. King in his road bus, actually, next to the Calvin. You know, hundreds of people that I got a chance to meet and have fun with.
Radio was so different back then because this is the pre-internet era, even pre-digital music era. You know, we were playing LPs to start with. CDs were just coming in at that point. Back then, we all worked a lot of hours and we had fun. You know, it was really a fun kind of Wild West place back then.
Whoa, buddy. Buddy Rubbish.
I was in the periphery of the Buddy Rubbish era, too, and he's one of the big legends of WRSI. There was a legendary story where the beaches at Puffer's Pond were going to be closed because they couldn't afford to keep them clean or something, and Buddy was like, "I'm not going to have it." So he said, "I'm going to broadcast from a raft in the middle of Puffer's Pond until we raise enough money to open the beaches up again." And so a lot of the dumb things that I've done over the years are based on that kind of notion. So, like, being stranded in the middle of downtown Northampton in a campsite in the cold to raise money for the Cancer Connection is a direct analog to that Buddy Rubbish on a raft in the middle of Puffer's Pond.
Coming up, we'll have bird songs today. We'll talk.
Oh, I do bird songs with Dan Zomek because everybody loves bird songs. It's sort of a hallmark of my show now, which I never thought would happen. But if I miss a day, people freak out.
Different is good. Mornings with Monty on the River.
This was another Facebook thing along Thursday.
It's unique,
request.
It's live, and I think there's more diversity in this area than you're going to find in the big cities.
It was allowed to kind of flourish in this way, in this soil of the Pioneer Valley, and become this thing that's very unique, like the Pioneer Valley is unique, in a way that's not so predetermined that, you know, you can flow with it a little bit, flow with the river, as it were.